こんばんは。フォレックス TV ニューヨークのレミです。9月29日月曜日の為替レポートニューヨークレビューをお伝えします。29日のアメリカ株式市場は急落しました。ダウ工業株30種平均の下げ幅は過去最大となりました。ダウ平均は前日比$777.68安の13,365.45で終えた。ナスダック総合株価指数は前日比199.61ポイント安の1,983.73で終えた。米会員は最大$7,000,000,000の不良資産を公的資金で買い取る金融安定化法案を賛成205、反対228で否決しました。共和党議員の大半が反対に回った上、民主党でも100人近くが反対票を投じました。ニューヨーク外国為替市場の円相場は続伸しました。米金融安定化法案の下院通過が不透明になったとの見方が広がり、円買いが加速しました。ドル円は103円98銭まで急落、ユーロ円は150円8銭と本日の安値を更新しました。さらにポンド円は188円13銭まで下落しました。それではウェルズファーゴの通貨ストラテジストバシリー・スレブリコフさんとのインタビューをご覧ください。
First and foremost, the US House has rejected the $700 billion bailout plan and the vote ended up228-205. And in terms of market reaction, we saw that US equities got slammed and the major indexes tumbled with the Dow down by over 700 points. Now in terms of the FX market, we've seen volatile thin trading and the dollar came off morning highs against both the euro as well as the sterling. But given that the bailout legislation has failed, for the time being, for FX traders out there, what's your advice?
Well, I think the key word that you just mentioned is volatility. And I think that's probably the only thing that benefits, so to speak, from this failed vote on the bailout. I think if you're looking at currencies, we're seeing the Japanese yen doing the best among the majors, which is not really a surprise. The dollar really suffered. But again, there's a lot of short-term movement. And I suspect most market players would prefer to stay out of the market at this point unless they have must-do business to conduct. It's a very volatile and uncertain environment right now.
Well, now that we've gotten the rejection of this billion-dollar bailout plan, let's focus on the credit crisis and how we're seeing it spread overseas. Now, over the weekend and overnight, we had the bailout of several European financial institutions, including the UK's Bradford and Bingley, and also the Benelux bailing out Fortis. But given that global central banks have been expanding FX swaps to boost liquidity, let's take a look at the euro first. Now, how are you incorporating the credit crisis spreading overseas into your euro-dollar forecast?
Well, we think, you know, it's not exactly a new development in the sense that we've had signs that the financial sector in the UK in particular, but somewhat in the eurozone, was catching some of this weakness. And those recent signs are just a confirmation. I think you know, the fact is that the credit crunch is global, and I think that's also why we think US dollar might be stronger next year, provided some of those measures like the bill that we just talked about get passed eventually. We think, you know, assuming it is passed, which is a big if, that will actually be a positive for the US economy in terms of unclogging the US financial system, sort of reviving bank lending, and will be a positive for the US growth going forward, and hence the US dollar. Whereas in the eurozone, it's a little bit of a delayed situation compared to what we have in the US. Those kind of problems are just starting to manifest themselves in a major way. And we think that's actually going to might weigh on the euro next year, whereas the dollar might already be through the worst part, if you want.
以上、ウェルズファーゴの通貨ストラテジスト、バシリー・スレブリコフさんとのインタビューでした。Forex TV ニューヨークのレミがお伝えしました。最新の為替情報については、Forex TV Japan をご覧ください。